You all look mighty nice out there this afternoon. Yeah, everybody looking good. They usually have a countdown, do they not? It's already had it? Oh, really? Oh, I thought it was 12:30. Okay, all right, my mistake. I'm getting ready to cool out, and I need to be on deck, huh? All right, I apologize for that, a little misunderstanding. Good afternoon. Praise God. It's a plum pleasing pleasure to be here with you. I am Dr. Franco Taylor. Anybody here for the first time? I've got one young lady here. Praise God. Thank you for coming. Who brought you? Who told you about it? All right. Thank you. What part of Illinois? Bowling Brook. All right. That's wonderful. I've been there once. I went out there fishing long. I grew up in Chicago. I got another young man out here. Thank you for coming. Well, everybody, does everybody remember? Anybody remember what we talked about last week?
Yeah.
What was it?
Don't eat meat.
That wasn't what we talked about, but that always comes out. Don't eat meat. That's good. Well, actually, you know, we talk a little bit about the Bible way to health, and then we talk a little bit about why these diseases come about, all these different diseases. And all of them had a particular, we call them the hit men. High blood pressure, heart disease, osteoporosis, diabetes. Those are the top killers today, okay? And they all were what I call hit men. And they all had a particular form of ammunition. They had a secret weapon that they used. Anybody tell me what the secret weapon was? Cholesterol. What woman said that? I'm point to her so I can see her. That was her? Okay, Louise, come to me afterwards. I got something for you. Because you all must understand that there's only two sicknesses, only two diseases. One is indigestion and the other one is constipation. Everything else is a symptom of that. So the physician's desk reference has thousands of diseases. They're playing with you, okay? They say, well, we've got a diet that we eat for our blood type, right? You heard of that? There's only one blood type. It's called JESUS. Okay, I'm trying to get you to understand. Yeah, we got some O's and some B positive and all that kind of thing, but it requires the same food that God told us to eat in the beginning. So we just realized that cholesterol is the big problem. We saw that cholesterol caused high blood pressure and heart problems, high blood, hypertension, all that, but it also caused what? Diabetes. Those that have diabetes, after a few months or a year, they're gonna have what? High blood. Those that have high blood, after a year or two, a year or whatever, they're gonna have what? Diabetes. Are y'all getting this? Why? Because they're caused by the same thing. Y'all remember we talked about that. We know that the arteries are clogged up because of the cholesterol, right? And cholesterol only comes from one place. Where is that? Meat, animal product. We just got to realize that. It's just true, okay? And again, I didn't say you're going to die and go to hell because you ate meat. Did I say that? No. I said that we simply needed to make sure we got what? Some live to go with it, right? Because live has everything that we need. So the bottom line is the cholesterol is a problem. We need to look out for that. So here we are eating a certain way. We eat lots and lots and lots of meat, okay? So my question is, how did we get to the point where we eat all of these animal products? Would anybody like to know how we got there? Okay, well, we're going to go to the Bible to see why we eat the way we do. Would y'all like to see it from the Word of God?
Yeah.
All right. I like this morning crowd. Y'all lively. Y'all on the, yeah, I like it. Okay. Let's take a look at some. We're going to look at our first slide. Or maybe I need to do the slide or something. Okay. Anybody remember that lady? Let's do one more, the next slide, so we'll know her then. Next slide. Okay, y'all remember her? Her name was Clara Peller. She was 80 years old, and in 1964, she did something. She walked up to a counter at Wendy's. I'm sorry, 1984. She walked up to a counter at Wendy's, took her bun back up there, opened it up, and what did she say? Where's the beef? Wasn't enough meat on the sandwich, right? That was 1984. I posit to you that that wasn't the first time that it was that where's the beef was spoken. I posit to you that thousands of years ago, someone said, where's the beef? We're going to go and check it. Next slide. Okay, that's something for Brown. Okay, next slide. Next slide. Okay, we're having a little technical, but bottom line, again, I'm saying to you that she wasn't the first one to say, where's the beef? Okay. What I'm going to do, okay. Why do we eat the way we do? Okay, if they're going to be looking at me real good, that's a good question. So the greatest medical book ever written is what? The owner's manual. What is it called? The B-I-B-L-E. All right, so that's where we're going to go to get this answer as to why we eat the way we do. Okay. Now, God's original diet for man was in what? Genesis 1:29. God said, I've given you every herb-bearing seed which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree in the which is the fruit of a tree yielding seed, to you it shall be for meat. So man's first meat or food was what? Fruit, nuts, and grains. Where did he eat? At the table of God, right? And how long was he supposed to live? Forever. So fruit, nuts, and grains was what? It was forever food. Am I right? It was forever food. All right. That's what the word said. All right. Now, God's original diet for the animals was Genesis 1:30. And so what he did was he took the green herbs and he said that would be for everything that crawled and flew and swam. So all the animals ate the green herbs. So they ate vegetables and legumes and so forth. And where did they eat? Around the what? The feet of man. They were in subjection to man. Man was in subjection to God. And that was the order of things. How long were the animals supposed to live? Forever. So everybody was supposed to live forever on that diet, right? And we also, in our first meeting, we talked about the fact that in Exodus 15:26, that obedience to the word of God would mean what? Health and life, right? And in Deuteronomy 28:15, we saw that disobedience to God's word would be what? Sickness and what? Death. And we know that's true because our first great, 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 great foreparents got in trouble for eating something they weren't supposed to eat. They disobeyed, didn't they? And when they disobeyed, what came into the world? Sin, sickness, and death. Ooh, you all are on top of this thing. That's good stuff. All right. Next slide. All right, God's remedial diet. Now, something happened because we do not live forever, do we? No, because of the problems that went down, the disobedience and the hiding and the fear and the fig leaves and all that kind of stuff. But the bottom line, God did something. In Genesis, the third chapter, verse 17 and 18, he said, cursed is the ground for thy sake. Thorns and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. Now man has to do what? Eat the same food as the what? As the animals. Y'all getting this? That's punishment. He didn't have to bend over and get his back bent and get his fingernails dirty. You know, he didn't have to do all that. I'll just let y'all know I can bend and move pretty good. At 74, that ain't bad, is it? That ain't bad at all. All right. So now he's eating the same. Not quite. He's eating the same food. He got to bend over. And his lifespan has been shortened because he was supposed to live how long in the beginning? Now we notice that Adam lived to be 930, Noah lived to be 950, and Methuselah lived to be 969. So they went from forever to almost 1,000 years. That's still pretty good, isn't it? All right, so that's pretty good, shortened lifespan, but we see things happen when you do what? Disobey, and when you do what? Eat wrong. Am I making sense? Okay, let's go a little step further. Now, reason why God destroyed the world, because they were going along pretty good, living to be 1,000, that was pretty good, but God decided, I've had enough. So what were some of the reasons? Genesis 6, 5, we found that his people were all out in the groves and in the garden worshiping what? Idols. They were having orgies and parties and you know, wrong folks were in bed with wrong folks and just all kinds of stuff, getting drunk in rivalry, all kinds of just craziness. And God decided to destroy them. And in Isaiah 66, 17, we see that they were doing something else. They were eating something that was called the hogs, the swine's flesh, and the mouse. That's what it says in Isaiah 66, 17. So let's look and see what a mouse is. They were eating hogs, rats, bats, opossums, and etc. Y'all remember not too long ago, a few years ago, that this thing, y'all remember COVID? How did it start? Bats. They were eating bats over in China somewhere in what they call a wet market. So the scriptures tell me that what has been shall what? Be required. As it was in the days of Noah, so it'll be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man. So right now, we're reliving what happened. Oh, y'all getting this. So it's not make-believe. It's not something that Dr. Franco made up. It actually took place. All right. So bats, in other words, when it says swine's flesh in the mouse, all things that look like that, rabbits and bats and squirrels and opossums and you know, things that look kangaroos, all we were eating all that kind of stuff. And these were basically, God called them what? Unclean. They were unclean animals. And we began to do what? Spread disease, sickness, and what? Death. Okay, our next one. Genesis 6:21. Now, God does something. He's destroying the world, but he repeats his allowance of the remedial diet. He gave us several diets. He gave us the perfect diet. That was the original diet, okay, the one that would keep us alive forever. Then he gave us the remedial diet, and he repeated it. Time out. I'd like to say something. Remedial means what? Remedy, making something better, healing or curing something, right? Remedy. There's a remedy in there. So why was this a remedial diet? Well, let's look at it now. Man is eating fruit, nuts, grains. Now he's eating vegetables. So I said to God, many, many years ago, why did you give him vegetables now? He said, because he needed them. His mind was messed up. He had lost his mind. And his blood was impure. How do we know his blood's impure? Because he's not going to live forever, right? So that means his blood wasn't as pure as it was in the beginning. He was getting sick, sickly and so forth. Cain was killing his brother. They were just, stuff was messed up because of sin, right? And so I said, but what was the difference? So what I did was I jumped out of the Bible. I jumped way over here into 1970. In 1970, the Crohn's Colitis Foundation, the Heart Foundation, diabetes, cancer, Alzheimer's, all of them got together, and they said that if man ate a certain food, all the incidences of those diseases would go away. What was the certain food? Fruit, nuts, grains, and vegetables. What kind of vegetables? Those cruciferous, those green vegetables. And so that's when it hit me. Oh, I see what you're saying, God. Oh, I got you, Lord. What he was saying was, inside of the vegetables was something special. It was green. What was it called? Chlorophyll. So the chlorophyll was the blood of the plant, and we've got heme or iron. We got our blood. And when you take them and put a molecule of each under a slide, guess what? They're identical. The molecular structure of blood and the molecular structure of chlorophyll are identical. Only difference is in the middle of the blood, you got heme or iron. In the middle of the chlorophyll, you have magnesium. But all the tinker toy, it's all the same. So what God was saying to me, okay, they needed that green stuff because their blood was what? Impure. It was tainted. So God gave them the chlorophyll as a what? A remedy, a blood transfusion. Woo! It's rich. It's good stuff, isn't it? This is good. Isn't that deep? That's scientific. Straight out the Word of God. The greatest medical book ever written. I'm taking my time because I don't want y'all to miss this. When y'all leave here, I want y'all to be able to go home and know that you can start getting better today. Does that make sense? All right. So at this point, The only food that God had commanded man to eat was what? Fruit, nuts, grains, and vegetables. And he told Adam, and he told Noah, and he told them to gather all the food that was eaten, and it shall be food for thee and for them. Who was them? The animals. So at that time, everybody was eating fruits, nuts, grains, and vegetables. Y'all got that. We saw some movies, y'all might have saw them, and they had Noah and the gang were eating hot dogs and sausages and, you know, like it was at McDonald's. That wasn't, no, everybody ate the same food. All right, so let's go to the next slide. Now, God's temporary diet, so we had a perfect diet, the original diet, then we had a remedial diet that was designed to do what? Help heal him back up a little bit, okay? Now we've got a temporary diet. Now, let's think about this. God destroyed the earth, right? And he brought with him the animals, and he brought them by what? Two. But if you ever go to chapter 7 and look at verse 1 and 2, you'll see that he took the unclean animals by what? Two. But he took the clean animals by what? Seven. Ooh, we got some studiers up in here. I like that. I never had that happen like that before. Everybody on the front row says seven. I wonder why. Could it possibly be that when the ark landed, there was no food? Because the vegetables and fruit, nuts, and grains was all what? Gone. And all that hadn't been eaten was what? Rotted. I mean, you know, y'all got that? So they had to eat something. So let's go and look at what happened. In Genesis, the 9th chapter, verse 1 through 5, God did something. He said, to be fruitful and multiply. In other words, he started all over again, right? And then he said, be fruitful and what? Multiply and do what? Replenish the earth. So they're going to put some more bodies just like themselves, and they're going to do what? Grow some greens and some watermelons. Y'all getting this? Peach trees, plum trees, grapes on the vine, scuppernong, all that kind of good stuff, all right? So they were going to grow some more vegetables. So in the next 6, 12 weeks or so, a couple of months, 2, 3 months, they'd have what? More food to eat. Which food was that? The ones that he had told them in the beginning, fruit, nuts, grains, and then he added vegetables. Y'all got that? All right. But then, because man had been cutting up, we told you what he was doing over in the groves, what he was eating, he did this. He said that all living things shall be food for you, even as the green herb. So I gave you fruit, nuts, grains, you sinned. I gave you vegetables. You kept on sinning. I destroyed the world. Now I'm going to let you eat some animals, okay? He said, but, in verse 5, the food with the blood in it, which is the life thereof, shall ye not eat. And every time you eat it, I'm going to require the blood of your life. Oh, so what he did was he gave them a warning that if you eat the animal, I'm going to give it to you, but when you eat it, I'm going to do what? I'm going to shorten your life. In some cases, you'll even what? Die. Y'all, oh boy, this is something. So then if we go to Leviticus 7, 22 through 27, let's see if we got that scripture up. I hope we do. Leviticus 7, 22 through 27. Next, it should be go back. That, they didn't get that slide for me. Basically, that slide showed something. It showed us that you shall not eat any fat in any of your dwellings. And any person that eats fat shall be what? Cut off from his people. You can go back and read that. And then it also says that anyone that drinks blood from any kind of an animal should be what? Cut off from his people. And then Leviticus 4:11 says, and it shall be a perpetual statute throughout all your generations that you eat neither fat nor blood. So there was a couple of scriptures there that prove that God never intended for man to eat what? Fat or blood with the animals if they were going to eat them, okay? So obviously there's something going on here. So let's look at this. So diabetes is caused by what? Too much what? Cholesterol. High blood pressure is caused by too much what? Osteoporosis was caused by too much what? Cholesterol. And where does cholesterol come from? Meat. And so God said never eat any what? Fat or blood. Do you think he knew that in 2024 we'd have diseases that were caused by too much fat or cholesterol? Do you think he knew that we'd have blood disease, cancer? Do you think he knew all of that? He didn't say it in a word. He didn't have to, did he? Because he was Papa. And he said, just don't do it. That makes sense? Okay, all right. So we want to make sure that eating fat or blood means disease and death. Next slide. All right, let's take a look at this. These are the generations around the flood. You'll look over there and you'll see Adam lived to be how old? 900 and what? 30. How about Seth? 912. So all of them lived basically to be 900 years there. But look at what happened immediately after the flood. Noah lived to be 950, but his son Shem lived to be how old? Whoa, we dropped 300 years. 300, almost 400 years. And then Shem's son, Arphaxad, lived to be how long? Another 200 and some years. And then Arphaxad's son, Selah, lived to be how old? 400, then 400. Then they dropped what? Peleg. Within five generations, they dropped from being almost 1,000 years old to being what? 200. Is that something? What was the only difference? Are we eating what? Meat. Do y'all see that? Did Dr. Franco make that up? It's in the Word. Okay, we want to see how we got to where we eat today. We're going to go to the next slide. We're going to move on now. Huh? All the way down to 70, huh? God said that I'll give you what? What was it? 60+10? If by reason of strength. That means that you might have a foot amputated, an arm amputated. You might be stroked up. You might be hooked to a dialysis machine. Am I making sense? That's not really living, is it? That's existing. Living is when you can, you know, you know, that's living. Huh? When you can pick something up off the floor, you know. When you can look down and see what color shoes you got on. Folks got one blue shoe, one white shoe. All right. So let's look at the next. And this is what it looked like. I'm sorry. Let's look at that. This is what it looked like. There were giants in that day. We were giants. Food grew way up in the air. They said that it took two men to carry a cluster of grapes. Can you imagine a bunch of grapes so big it took two dudes to carry it? Can you imagine a grape the size of a watermelon? You bite into it, juice just goes everywhere. I want us to smile and laugh, but I want us to understand. This is real, folks. We are dwarfed and pitiful compared to what we once were. But we don't have to keep going back that way. We can stop here and start coming back this way. All right, next slide. We're going to move on. So the origin of where's the beef? If we go in our Bibles to Numbers 11:4-9, God's people preferred slavery to not having flesh or beef. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just take us there. Okay. In Numbers 11:4, and God had just allowed Moses to bring the children of Israel out of bondage. They hadn't been out of bondage 4 or 5 weeks. Y'all getting me? They just got out. They still got the marks of the Pharaoh's bonds on them. And this is what they did. It says, and the mixed multitude, and the people stood up all that day and all the next night. And I'm opening the wrong. Numbers 11:4. And the mixed multitude that was among them fell a-lusting. And the children of Israel also wept again and said, where's the beef? That's not what they said. They said what? Who shall give us flesh to eat? Is that not the same thing? Y'all hear what I'm saying? Where's the beef? Oh, my goodness gracious. Let's look at this a little bit here. So now the next verse, 5, says, we remember the fish which we did eat in Egypt freely, the cucumbers and the melons and the leeks and the onions and the garlic. But now our soul is dried away. There is nothing at all besides this manna before our eyes. And the manna was as coriander seed, and the color thereof was the color of delium. And the people went about and gathered it and ground it in meals or beat it in mortar and baked it in pans and made cakes of it. And the taste of it was as the taste of fresh oil. So let's look at what happened. We read the Bible and we say, what was manna? Manna was what? Bread from heaven. It was light bread. It was angel food, angel bread. But here the Bible tells us that it was actually what? Like little seeds. And the seeds were golden colored. Delium is a golden color, golden brown, right? And it says they gathered them, then they beat them in the mortar, okay, ground them all up, and they made them into flour, and they made cakes out of it, and they baked it, and it was like the taste of fresh oil. So it was really bread, right? And there's a principle there about the manna being bread, okay? And then it says after they had done all the work, and now they're working for their food, remember? So they work for the food, it says, and they gathered it all up. And then it says, and the people went about and gathered it and ground it. But in verse 9 it says, and when the dew fell upon the camp in the night, the manna fell upon it. So God gave them manna. He gave them this bread from, this honey bread, this bread from heaven. And there was a reason for it. Because there's another scripture. Something else happens here. So in the 9th verse, I'm sorry, the 10th verse, still Numbers 11:10 says, Moses heard the people weep throughout their families. Every man in the door of his tent, the anger of the Lord was kindled greatly. So the people mad at Moses. Moses is afraid, okay? And God is mad because his man has to be afraid. And Moses said unto the Lord, wherefore hast thou afflicted thy servant? And wherefore, in other words, Moses, I won't go through all of it. Moses is saying, Lord, there ain't enough Mickey D's in this vicinity for me to feed all these brothers and sisters beef. There are not that many Colonel Sanders in this vicinity. I don't know what to do. I'm afraid. And they're getting angry. I think they might kill me. If I have favor in your sight, you kill me. I'd rather for you to take me out than them tear me from limb to limb over a piece of chicken. Huh? Over a drumstick? No, sir. Not over some doo-doo shoots. Y'all know those chitlins, right? Oh, okay. All right, all right. We'll keep moving. We'll keep. That was deep, wasn't it? That's pretty deep. Okay. I ate my share, so I understand, I understand. So bottom line, Moses is afraid. And so Moses says, God, kill me, because I can't handle it. And so God says, you get together me 70 men, 70 of the elders, and bring them before me, and I'm going to talk to them. And in verse 18, he says, and say thou unto the people, sanctify yourselves against tomorrow, and ye shall eat flesh, for ye have wept in the ears of the Lord, saying, who shall give us flesh to eat? Where's the beef? For it was well with us in Egypt. Therefore, the Lord will give you flesh and you shall eat. In other words, you would rather be in slavery, in bondage, so that you could have some Mickey D's sausage McMuffins in the morning. You'd rather be enslaved just so you could get some greasy pizzas. Y'all see that? These are God's people. They were closer to God than we are. And thousands of years ago. Come on, come on, come on, come on. All right, so he said, because you, who shall give us flesh to eat? For it was well with us in Egypt. Therefore, the Lord will give you flesh, and ye shall eat. He says, but even a whole, ye shall not eat 1 day, nor 2 days, nor 5 days, nor 10 days, or 20 days, but even a whole month until it comes out at your nostrils and be loathsome unto you, because you have despised the Lord which is among you and have wept before him, saying, why came we forth out of Egypt? Why did you deliver us? We like hot wings with buffalo sauce. And you brought us out here in this wilderness and you've given us this manna, this bread from heaven. Was that appreciation? None. All right, so let's look at that. He said, until it be loathsome to you and come out at your nostrils. Have you ever sat at the dinner table and got down? I mean, got down, 2-3 helpings. And then your nose started running. Have you ever been eating, get full, and your nose started running? Gotta wipe your nose. That's sinus, folks. And it comes when you're eating all of that what? Animal products, or even too much sugar. Your immune system starts trying to get rid of that stuff, and it does what? It starts causing all that mucus to form in your body. Y'all listening to me? He just said until it gets loathsome. I mean, loathsome means ooh, and it starts coming out at your nostrils. Can I get any plainer than that? God is trying to help you to see why you're sick. All right. So let's do this then. We're gonna look at. So it says, because God didn't, they didn't appreciate what God had done for them by sending Moses to them. And so now we're gonna go over to John. We're almost done. We're gonna go over to John, and we're gonna go to John the. Our next scripture should tell us there where we're going in John. We're going to go to John, the sixth chapter, and we're going to look at 47 through 51. And it simply says this, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, is that right? Everybody with me? Okay. He that believeth on me hath everlasting life. I am that bread of life. Your fathers did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. So let's look at this now. They were over there in the wilderness, and they were eating the manna, and they dead. They gone, right? But they had the manna to eat. Now, let's go and see if we can't tie this thing together. It says, and they are dead. This is the bread which cometh down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and not die. So he was saying, the bread that I was sending to them was what? It was me. I was giving them the bread of life. They missed it. Oh, come on, folks. We don't want to miss it today, though, do we? No, we don't want to miss a day. All right. So he says here, I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live for how long? Forever. And the bread that I will give is what? My flesh, which I will give for the life of the world. Now we're seeing something here. So the bread represented the body of God. Oh, wow, this is deep. Verse 53 says, verily, verily, I say unto you, except ye eat the flesh. Wait a minute now. God is, Christ saying we can eat some flesh. Before that, we weren't supposed to eat. Something changed. Just look at this. He said, except ye eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood. Now he's saying we can have some blood. Over there, he forbade us to deal with blood. Are y'all getting me? Oh, boy, something good. You better watch out. You talking about the Lord's Supper, brother. You better watch out, boy. You be preaching to me. You ought to come on up here with me. Good God Almighty. Boy, you better watch out. All right. So he says, whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed. My blood is drink indeed. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me, and I in him. As the living Father hath sent me, and I live by the Father, so he that eateth me, even he shall live by me. This is that bread which came down from heaven. Not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead, he that eateth of this bread shall live forever. So bottom line, I want y'all to work with me a little bit. I want to see if y'all got some voices out there and if y'all with me on this deal. Now, we just saw that Christ's flesh is the only flesh that gives life, right? And we saw that Christ's blood was the only blood that gave life. That means that all other flesh and all other blood must give what? Death. Life and death is in the blood. The blood that Jesus shed for me. All right, anyway. So, bottom line, are y'all seeing this? Let's go back over the numbers, and we'll finish out. And then I'm going to ask something else of you here. Numbers 11. My fingers are switching all past my page here. So we're going to go back to Numbers 11, and we're going to go to the verse 32 and verse 33. And we left them. God had told them that they were going to get sick and diseased. They're going to have mucus all in their body, inflammation all in their body, right? Bronchial, congestive heart failure, all that mucus, right? But that was if they went on and ate it. So you would think they would say, well, okay, we're going to back up. We're going to eat what you told us to eat in the beginning. No. Let's look and see what they did. In verse 32, it says here, and the people stood up all that day and all that night and all the next day, and they gathered the quails. He that gathered the least gathered 10 omers, and they spread them all abroad for themselves in the camp. So they saying they gathered all these quails, all them dead birds that come in, blood and feathers everywhere, guts is everywhere. And they was heaping it up in their tents, right? And it said the ones that gathered the least, the smallest amount, had over 10 homers. That's almost up to their knees in quail. They stacking them up so they can eat them. Wow. Greedy rascal. Kentucky Fried Chicken eating rascals, boy, I tell you. Verse 33 says, and while the flesh was yet between their teeth, before they could chew it, God, it said, the wrath of the Lord was kindled against the people, and the Lord smote the people with a what? A very great flood. A flood, right? It was a plague. In other words, could that possibly have been, next slide. Could that possibly have been, next slide, that's not my slide. Okay, so we're going to ask the question now, why did God allow man to eat? Because see, what we're talking about there is COVID. We're talking about diabetes. We're talking about heart problems. We're talking about AIDS, pneumonia. All those plagues that we are going through today caused basically by eating wrong. So let's look at something. Why did God allow man to eat it? If we go to Deuteronomy, we go to Deuteronomy, the 12th chapter, and we're going to finish up, and I'll open up for questions. We just want to make sure we saw this. And Deuteronomy, the 12th, ooh, I just licked my fingers. If my wife saw me do that, she's going to get me. Ooh, she's going to get me. You know that's right, don't you? Got no business licking no fingers up in here. So, Deuteronomy, the 12th chapter. Listen carefully, folks. Deuteronomy 12, 15 says, notwithstanding, thou mayest kill and eat flesh in all thy gates, whatsoever thy soul lusteth after. What did I say? Lusteth after. Is lust a good thing? Oh, okay, okay. Well, let's go. Verse 20 says, when the Lord thy God shall enlarge thy border, as he hath promised thee, and thou shalt say, I will eat flesh. I'm on some beef. Thou mayest eat flesh, whatsoever thy soul does what? Lusteth after. Oh, verse 21. If the place which the Lord thy God has chosen to put his name there be too far from thee, thou shalt eat the herd of thy flock, which the Lord hath given thee, as I have commanded thee, and thou shalt eat in thy gates whatsoever thy soul lusteth after. So, folks say, well, God didn't intend for me to eat meat. Why did he tell us which one was clean and which one wasn't? Because the unclean gonna kill your behind quickly. The clean would at least give you what? A little more life. Is that making any sense? God gives you the desires of your heart. They lusted for you. Help me out a little bit. I want to see a show of hands of all of you who have given your children, your grandchildren, your nieces, your nephews, given some child some candy in your day. Raise your hand if you've given them some candy. Now keep your hands up if you knew the candy was good for them when you gave it to them. Y'all know that candy wasn't good for them. It was good to them, but it wasn't good for them. You knew that it was going to give them upset stomach, going to rot their teeth, send them. You got to pay the dental bill, make them stomachs upset. Huh? So why'd you give it to them? Because you loved them. And you didn't want them to not have what they wanted, even though it wasn't good for them. So don't you dare think that you would care more for your children than God would care for you. He'll give you what you want. Even if you want to drink some poison, he'll try to admonish you not to, but he can't just stop you. There's so much evil out here that somebody is going to die prematurely. Somebody's going to get shot. But this is not God's will. But there's some things that we do to ourselves that definitely are not God's will. So health is not a chance. It's a what? It's a choice, people. Praise God. Do y'all see how we got to eating the way we do? And you have a choice. You can keep eating like that. Ain't nobody going to look down on you. I ain't going to say nothing about your plate. Every time I go in the grocery store, for the last 30 years, somebody ease up and look over in my buggy. They want to see if Brother Franco has changed. And here it is, 30 years of being back in Memphis, the buggy still looks the same, loaded with live food. Okay? All right. Questions, anybody? I hope you all see that. How we got to eat in the way we do is because that's what we wanted to do. Had nothing to do with God's original purpose in our lives. God has what is called a perfect will, and he also has something that's called a permissive will. He'll allow you to do things like adultery. Well, not adultery. Well, it is called adultery once you do it, but getting married because of irreconcilable difference. What in the world is an irreconcilable difference? We're in it to win it. I mean, if somebody beating you on you and carrying on, yeah, that's, you know what I'm saying? But just because you didn't cook my sausage the right way, huh? I don't like the way you put my sweet tea, ain't sweet enough. Okay, folks. Any questions? Any questions? Yes, question. Yes. It is. That's true. Absolutely true. In other words, she's saying that people get stuck on the myth that God said, that they said everything that God made was good. It was. It was good for a purpose, you know. Hog was good because he eats up all the garbage, dead rats, dead people. He'll eat up anything dead, anything dead. So he's a garbage can. The catfish is the garbage can of the sea. Shrimp, crab, they eat. So they're delicious. I eat them. But they just ain't good for you. They're going to kill you slowly. Like I said, you kill them to eat them, they reach back up out of the grave. And they get you. Am I making sense? Yes. The question is, if cholesterol is the problem, what's wrong with the egg white if the yolk is where the cholesterol is? Let's look at this thing. All right, let's look at this thing. Now, we know, y'all, it was just Easter a couple of weeks ago. Anybody go to an egg hunt? Anybody dye any eggs for the children? Nobody, y'all don't do that anymore? But y'all remember when we used to get them eggs that were dyed all pretty and purple? And when you cracked the shell, what color was it inside? Purple. Why? Because the egg shell is porous. It's actually the skin, get me? Okay, it's the skin of the baby chicken. The yolk is the chicken. All the white is his membranes around him. And so all of the poisons and toxins that go in through the shell get into the what? Into the white. So you won't get cholesterol from the whites, but you'll get all the poisons, toxins, bacteria, cancer-causing materials, you know, jump out of the frying pan into the fire. Does that make any sense? Okay, God's good. Question, anyone? Yes, question. Oh. I got you. Okay, my dear sister says, I never really kind of thought of it that way, that possibly God was giving them the manna as a detox so that he could clear out their systems and what? They would be able to listen to him even more clearly. I can go along with that. That sounds good because it was. It was meant to be, it was sort of a replacement of the fruit, nuts, and grains. So it was the perfect food because he gave it. It was his body, all the pure. Wow, that's deep. I like that. Good, 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 good stuff, good stuff. And your children after thee. I didn't read that because I was looking at the time. I usually do that. So bottom line, over there where it was said, lusted for it, okay, it simply said, don't you eat it, and especially women that are pregnant. Just eat in and everything they want to eat. Anything, because they're pregnant, right? Pickles, drink wine, beer, just everything, eat everything. Hog noses, they eat it all. And then they get sick. But it says the baby might be born undeveloped, might be stillborn, might be born with something missing or wrong, because all the garbage in the food that she ate, the DNA affected the child. Oh, y'all getting me? Just like smoking and drinking, And snorting cocaine and all that kind of stuff can affect the baby. That's very, very good, sister. Very good, very good. You have to go with me in my next preaching. Yes, ma'am. Okay.